Hello, welcome to another review for the week ended July 17, 2020. My name is Ambrose Omodio. This week, we're looking at how the market has performed for the week under review and the direction in the new week we're crossing to. Now, I will tell you that the market for the week under review was purely a missed market, just like what happened in the previous week. But the good thing is that the market continued to resist what further decline. Before we go into looking at the chart, I want to give you the market data for the week. The Usher Index opened at 24,306.36 points and closed at 287.66 points, losing 18.70 points, and that represents a negative 0.08% for the week. That means the market lost marginally. And if you remember that, in our last review, I said the market lost 0.12 for the previous week. That means market is resisting further decline. I'm gonna go to the chart. The chart will review this for you. But if you look at also the sectoral performance, just like what happened in February, that the banking sector led the market and supported the market, for that week. Also, the week under review, the only sector that was up for the week for this week under review is the industrial goods, gaining just marginal 0.252%. It tells you that the market is still struggling, not very struggling, but resisting to go down. That tells you that there's something that the market is looking at. Buyers at this time are not ready to take risk. That means they are fearful. That sends you a signal that what will I do? And also, when you say when people are fearful in the market, and when people are fearful, what do you do? You become greedy. But when people are greedy, you become what? Fearful. Now that people are fearful, that means there's something they are looking at that's making them not to go into the market, which is especially the earnings season, which I've been discussing for a period of time now. The second quarter earnings season of half year earnings season. This result is what is sending people are factoring in because they let's see the number first. But I will tell you, because the market are expecting this, a disappointing or in some of a depressed number for the second quarter, which might also affect the half year of many companies, then they are not taking position. But I will tell you, when this number will start coming, there will be not much reaction to that negative result or the disappointing result we're expecting, because it has been factored in. People are still holding cash to see. People are sitting on the fence to see this number. But when they see that these numbers are not as bad as they expected, you see, gradually they'll start coming back to the market. And don't forget that in the previous day, we were discussing other factors that will trigger the market. I'm telling you, the rate at which the world is going towards, discovering vaccine for COVID-19, if that is achieved in this second half of the year, I'm telling you, it will quicken the market recovering locally and what internationally. Why did I say so? Because once that fear is off and many nations start relaxing their lockdown, even though they're planning for second lockdown, they forget about planning for the second round because there's always already a vaccine. That also will trigger consumption of oil. I know that in our nation here, our major source of revenue is oil. And when oil the price move up again, it's a positive sentiment for our market. Not only that, it's going to also reflect on our reserve. And I said earlier that the CBN achieving one unification or one exchange rate is a plus for also for the market, because now we are not an exporting country in terms of other goods that will attract inflow in terms of trade. But the trade kind of trade that we are seeing now is that our assets this part of the world will become cheaper because of the devaluation of naira. No, that alone also going to impact positively going forward into the second half of the year. For me, investors should just relax and work and take decision that will also profit them. And that is why, before I go further, if you have not gotten your mastering earnings video, you need to do that, because what I'm seeing playing out already before the earnings season is what we really discussed in that video. It will give you strategies. Like I told people that I've been calling, that earnings season is as old as equity market. That means if you know the strategy how to make money on quarterly basis and full year, it's another way of adding to your what or your source of income. On that note, I expect that investors should get the material and what and learn more. Like other people that if you learn more, you earn more, you make more profit. That is for that. You need to up your game in terms of knowledge. If you look at what happened in the market for the last, let's say, from the month of April to date, this is a daily chart I want to show you now. Before we move to the quickly chart, look at what happened. This was when the market touched the lowest point, that it hit the 11-year low before market rebound in April. But I want to show you something that this is the first moving average, and this one is called 20 days moving average. Market moved for like 4 days before it crossed the first moving average. And you know when the index action or index movement is above the moving average, it's a sign of bullish market. And because you can see before now, it has been under the 20-day moving average. It said that the market was sick, was really bearish. But when you see the market crossing the first moving average of 20, it's a sign that this market is going up. You have to hold on. And not only that, it went as high as the profit taking, but market rebounded. When it crossed the 50-day moving average, it said that the rally or the movement is strong. There is a bullish run that is strong. For that, you see, it moved as high as even to the end in the month of June. No, but when the market break out this bearish channel, it broke it out. It tested it. It came down. It broke it down. But look at what happened. That's why I'm not saying. Market was up this period. Market started here. I see that this was a sideways movement here until the market crossed down the first moving average, and that first moment was 20 moving average. It's a sign of weakness. The market is tired. Market is gradually going down, and that is what we call at this point now. Market is entering what we call distribution stage. Distribution stage, and at this way you can see market remain below the 20 days moving average. It tells that the market is weak. All this we are seeing here, you can see that for almost more than seven trading days, market was in red. You can see from here, market was coming down. But once we enter the month of the last trading day of June, market rebounded in these 2 days before it gave up for the month, for the end of the month negative, and month of June ended negative, because you can see that distribution stage now was still on, but it now enter a decline stage. That decline stage is when it was confirmed when it crossed down the 50 days moving average. And you can see that the market, after crossing down the 50 days moving average, because of fear of this earnings season that we're expecting, the market also started trending again. You can see that the market has not touched the low that he did. That was a 23.90. So it has not touched that level again. So then it has remained up. That means market is also resisting for that decline. And you can see this trend here. This on a daily chart. But what the chart formation or the candlestick formation for the last trading day of the week, which was Friday, it says that the market has almost gone as low as touching what the beginning of the last previous day, which was on Thursday, and it closed what up and lost marginally. It tells you that this is a sign that the market is refusing to go down. But the fear also, you should know again that for me, if market is resisting to go down, and the volume traded is declining, it's a sign that people are waiting and people are not ready to sell because they see that there's other potential ahead apart from the earnings season. But they want to see this number. When this number comes, I'm telling you that this number will not go as bad as expected, and some company will also surprise you, like what happened last week or the week under review, that the two results that came to the market, one from Union Home Real Estate Investment Trust, that result was missed, and also don't expect much from them, because knowing that this pandemic is really hitting the property market or the estate market, because many business now are struggling even to pay rent. Not only that, with the innovation and the global research changes we are seeing, many people are working from home. That means offices that are having about 12 floor they are occupying now, no matter how big that, they can reduce their office to like 5. And that is a bad market for what? For the real estate business. That means all these commercial properties will really be under stress now, because people will likely be working from home, because internet and all, just to keep the rules of not contacting this. It's not only that, it's also another way of companies managing what their cost. For me, that sector of the market or the business of many will be struggling now until 2023, I will tell you, until 2023, when things are improving again. But for now, the real estate business will be struggling. And for me, if you are looking that way, you have to be very careful. That is not the way to look at now. You look at other sector. That, and also, if you consider the result from United Security, which is United Capital, that stock result or the company result for me was impressive. But don't forget that this company also, during the period, they were born to inject fresh funds to their operation. And the good thing that they took advantage of the market rebounding in April, knowing that that is the way they play most. That as an investment company, they do more on investment, and they took advantage and they made money. But for me, it's a sign that this company, if the market also rebound in this second half, it's a company that investors will be looking at, especially for those long-term investors that look at dividend. If you look at the company earning per share as at the end of June 30th, 2020, that means the first half, the earning per share for this company stood at what, 32 kobo against 27 kobo in 2019. That means despite the pandemic, this company were able to make profit. Yes, we expect that because of their bond, it might also put stress on them when you factor it in. When it comes to dividend, they might have to take care of the bond first before the ordinary shareholder, you and I. But the numbers speak now that this company is going somewhere. That means even for traders, it can be targeting this kind of company. Look, especially now we have seen the impressive number there. If the market rebound between August and September, or even towards the end of the last quarter of the year, you should expect that this company should give you a better result. That yes, you should expect good dividend from them, even when the dividend cost. Because a company that is selling below 3 naira and the earning yield as we speak now, or dividend yield as we speak now, is about 18% something, far above the inflation, is a stock that I can look at. Even when they cut a dividend, they will still going to pay you a good dividend. You can see in the history of the company, in the last 5 years, they have been consistent in dividend paying, and not that paying impressive dividend when you compare it to their price. For me, investors should not look. That also should give you an insight which sector, as we speak now, was also going to benefit from this pandemic, and that is where you should be looking at. But before we go that, I want to quickly go for the weekly chart so that you also see what I'm saying here, because chart will always tell you. You can look at this trend here. I've mentioned the last period that the market touched the 11 years low. But once we were looking at this current weeks, look at it for the almost 3 weeks now, the market is in the red for on a weekly chart. But you can see this pattern is forming here, market resisting to go down. It touched the 20 days moving average on a weekly chart, and the next one it didn't, it was shortened because it lost just 0.08 for the week. But this market, you can see that it's also another sand trend that has started again. That means until we see the earnings and also the outcome of MPC meeting by Monday, that will give you an insight where the market is going. But for me, I will say that again, investors should not panic, because the government and the government, including CBN, as they are trying to make sure that this economy is restart and also how will I put it now, jump started again to give direction. When we see that recovering, it was going to play out on the equities. You know that the market have rallied in the last months without the economic reality on the opposite movement from the market. But if we start seeing a recovery in the economy with all the injection of funds and implementation of the budget that was signed in, if the government will change their style of implementing and start seeing the impact of these things on the economy and on the companies and on activities of people, you see, it will going to have an effect on the market. Especially now that inflation figure continue to look up, for the statistics that were released yesterday, that was on Friday from the Bureau of Statistics, it tells that inflation again has even moved above the NPR. that is why we want to see what the CBN is doing, the metropolis are doing at the board. For me, I think they are likely to leave things out to see the impact of, you know, the injection and all the critical intervention they are doing in different sector, and also this exchange rate that was, you know, unified to have one exchange rate for every business in Nigeria, and also try to add more equity or more commodity that they will not make provision for import. That will also help us to conserve our reserve. Let's see, but I believe that CBN will not adjust anything in this their next MPC. But what we are saying, that if really we are going to go into economic recovery, because already we have seen that we are in a late contraction, which we have struggled. Now, if the CBN decisions or policies now will usher us into early, you know, expansion. And, you know, during early expansion, you expect that interest rate will be looking down, which we have seen over enjoy for a while. And also, gradually, you see that the industrial output is also looking up, which we expect that all the intervention will trigger productivity and, you know, give us a direction in terms of, increasing. Now that we're saying that agriculture is the major focus of the government, also they are looking the way of, making sure that the major critical sector has, come form of help to make sure that the business are running, that they won't, lay off their staff. We'll see that this will start playing out on the economy. And that, you see that in the early stage of economic recovery of any company, any economy, we expect that interest rate will be looking down, why the inflation will be slightly up, which we are seeing already, but industrial output will start coming up before you now move to the mid-expansion. That mid-expansion, you see that inflation will start going down in the way of, gradually going down in the way of interest. Then interest will start coming up gradually again. And also you expect that industrial output will also be looking up. This we expect that will play, and I believe CBN or monetary policy will not adjust more. They might leave everything unchanged for a while again to watch before their next MPC, because the decision they have taken this period, now that the 2.3 trillion has been injected into the economy budget, now that will trigger inflation actually, because at the same time, because of the insecurity in the system, high cost of transportation just to manage the pandemic, and bad roads again, it's also affecting this. But I believe with time we'll get it right and we'll start seeing inflation coming down, because actually when the cost of transportation is high, no matter what you preach, even though the goods is cheap in the market, the farms bringing it out, considering the bad road, those farmers, those marketers or those sellers will go and pick those goods, they'll factor the cost of transportation. Now that we're also, because of we're observing the social distance rules for us to contain this COVID-19, then we are carrying, instead of a bus to carry like normal 16, they are carrying just 8. You have to multiply the price, but the fuel they are using also is up. These are the area we are infected, are concerned that the government trying to make a better living by injecting from increasing cost of fuel, knowing that this season all these are what is playing out in the market. That's why inflation will continue to look up. If you look at it, it's the food basket of inflation that's really push it up. For me, let's see what will come out from the MPC meeting. But this is saying that the market on its own, in terms of sentiment and looking at the pattern, that the market is resisting further decline, even when we're expecting a depressed number. Tells you that investors has already factored in this number we're expecting into the price of equity we're seeing. That means you need to watch and just exercise patience. Like I said earlier, that if you are playing market now, especially if you're a short-term trader, don't trade with all your phone. You can trade with just 30% of your phone, just to enter some stock and pray and wait for this market to bottom out when after the any season we have seen the position of this company. But you can still play like those that I said, if you have access to the any massive any season, this is the time for you to take advantage of it, where you can look at the company that are within the value area. Technically, I will call it in between the resistance and the support. That value area is very important to watch. You see, where is the stock in this season? Where is the stock at this period? It tells whether you should jump in, that when it break out the resistance, it will go up. You know that it's always good to buy stock when it's breaking out a resistance, or when it's touching the support level and bouncing back. These are the key points we'll be looking at as trader at this point. Like I always said, that investing in equity is one of the best ways to what to make more money. But you need a what? A plan. You need a plan. This is where investors are getting it wrong. You need a plan, and this plan will consist of your objective, why you are investing. You have a good buying strategy and exit strategy at all time, especially if you're a trader. You must have this, and you have knowledge, understand how the capital markets work, how the stock market operates. If you understand this, you will succeed. You will succeed. That means you must have a plan and knowledge to succeed in trading equity, because this is the best way, one of the best way I see that you can grow your wealth. This is the best way I see you can grow your wealth. And that is what we preach investor, how to multiply what you have. Yes, like all the people that, anybody that tell you that you don't lose money in capital market, run away from that person. No, but let your, you know, your winning side be more than your losing side. That is the only thing. There's always a time for you to make to record losses. But you do now, you are price strategy. Like I always say again that after applying your technical analysis, your fundamental, the next thing that you apply is patient. There are some stuff that you sell off this morning in the market before in the afternoon the stock rebound. But if you are selling because what attracted you to that company is disintegrating, is no fading away, it's a different thing. But if what attracted you is staying intact and you see that there is potential, you can hold than selling in loss, especially if you have lost more than 20% of that position. But when you see that something that attracted you to that company are not there, I'm telling you, even when you have lost 50%, you can still quickly come out and move to another, no, thing entirely. Stocks are not wife that we say we want to hold. This is very important. That's why you need to have up your knowledge, so that if you up your knowledge, learn more to earn more. If you are buying a stock, a quality company or equity before the big run up or the mid move, in what we expect that you will sell? Why is that? If you are buying a quality company or stocks, you need to buy it before what the big move in value and sell it at what are the proper profit target. Don't just say because it's going up, have a target. That is why in our buy and sell signal, you see, if you are following us, we'll have our buy range. If you log into that signal, you see the buy range. At the same time, you see the stop loss. The stop loss we use for every position is 7% if you are a trader, because you want capital to trade. That means that in that buy range, we might have given you the stop loss using the least buy range, the least limit of the buy range, and you buy in between the range. We have not given you the stop loss. Automatically you factor in your 7% on that price. But even though you bought at the last range, for example, now like our position for MTN that will be coming up is within our range, is buy MTN between the range of 115 to 120 or 122. If you are buying it, then you need to know where to factor your stop loss as what, as a trader or investor, because we do not know exactly the price, but we are giving you a buy range to go ahead and do. You know the right then, but the ones, if you buy the price range of the low price, which you have calculated the stop loss in the signal, you take, you know, work it. Times you also have a stop, a profit target that will tell you the why, reason why we are buying it. And the period, is it for the weekly traders? Is it for the 6 months and for what? And for the 1 year investor? These are the things you see easily on the buy side. We also give you stock to sell for the week and stock to hold. When you have all this, it will guide you to take your investment decision. You won't be waiting to be looking at what will I do? No, even though you are engaged, that signal will just log in on Monday morning and take your what investment decision. Like I said, if you buy a quality company or stock before a big move or a big run in value and sell it at the what, at a proper profit target, don't wait. There are most times after we have given sell alert, people want to wait. They want to make more profit. The price start going down. That means when it goes down, we can enter by because we have sold. You that are waiting, you be, you know, have a set goal for your investment so that you won't be moving up and down. That is what. And I said to myself earlier again, learn more to earn more. If you want to make more profit in the market, you need to also up your game. There is what we are doing now. The 9 investing rules that will guide you. No, we call it 9 investing rules. I think I will make it available to our subscribers so that they will have to see that 9 rules. No, yes, we are giving you a stop loss. No, that you should have for traders. We want to give you other rules that will guide you to trade, no, profitably in the market. When you know all this, you will go a long way to make money. Yes, we'll continue from the review of the market. If you look at the market, I've just said there now, market is resisting a further decline. And sectorial rotation that is going on, you can see that, you know, the healthcare sector is not one or is not among the sectorial, you know, indicators we are studying, even the telecoms. But I will tell you that this sector, there's activities going on there already. The banking sector too, there's activities going on. People are looking at this banking sector, what to do, especially as, you know, there's signal that the banks will pay interim dividend. Considering that their interim dividend is slow, as I've said earlier. For me, you need to also wait small to see this bank adjust down and take position. But we also look at the ones that have good yield. You know, they are the banks that you should look at their payment at this point, even at this price, that has a better yield. Knowing that during the earnings season that we're already that have kicked off, you know, last week, there are companies that are going to post depressed number. Those that are going to post dividend that give small thing to investor will be where investors will be interested. Even at their waiting, they go there, take that distributable dividend, because you are everybody's in the market to make money. That means you as an investor should be looking at what are those entry dividend paying stock that are likely to do well and pay. That is why, like those in telecoms, expect that their entry dividend will come, because naturally they are making money and they're going to maintain what they pay, if not, you know, increasing the dividend, entry dividend they paid the previous day. Despite most of them are gone for bond, because the business they are now is on the uptrend because of the impact of the pandemic and the one gaining from this activities that is going on, this situation in the economy globally. For that, we expect them to do well. And also, if you look at those advanced countries that have released results, especially for that sector, so most of their numbers are better. But for those advanced countries that also have released no result from the financial sector, they are all increasing their worth, their lost reserve, their loan loss reserve, which is likely to also repeat itself here. But I believe that our banks are strong enough, especially the first tier banks that are likely to pay dividend, and they have robust, you know, retained earnings. And on that, I'm not afraid that they are paying dividend, and considering that this interest they are going to pay is small. Like I said earlier, if you expect them to cut their dividend, it will be at the end of the year. And but if you are entering at a good price, at a low price, you don't have fear. These are how to invest now. But before we round up, we want to quickly look at the top gainers for the week. Want to look at the top gainers for the week and reason why they gain, and also the loser for the week. If you look at Qt's topping the gainers chart or the advancer chart with 10.30% for the week, Qt is market sentiment, and also the markdown ahead of the markdown for the 12th Kobo dividend they declare. Now for Police Microfinance, yes, we're expecting their second quarter results. Like I tell you, that this company is sitting on a lot of funds. They are involved in police pension fund and all those stuff. We expect their results not to be bad as such, but flat, because if you look at their first quarter number, result was not so bad. And ahead of it, the market also, the stock also gained 10% for the week on that review. Then insurance company, the Sunwing Assurance, this one too also was insurance company, but you know what is helping insurance company because of the capitalization and also the low price attraction. But you need to also be very careful when we are buying into all this low cap stock at this point, because if the low cap stock comes with, you know, a depressing number or a negative result, you are going to be hooked in that. But you have to be very careful. Open your eyes and invest with you know, insight of what is likely to come from this company. That's why you also need to get the video. As I said, if you look at it, you tell you, once you see this number, you don't need to wait for the next second. When a company, especially a trader, post a number that is below market expectation, quickly sell off before you lose more than what's expected for you to lose, and move to the next one. Don't wait. And also, you want to look at company that is rallying. When you see that factor that is moving that company, especially if it's institutional investor that is buying to the company and it's going up, once you know that institutional investor is also building up, build out with them at the same time. These are the rules we're going to be giving you in the next video, or make it in form of a download for our subscribers and the followers to download, and it will also guide them for their activities, especially at this period and going forward into the year and beyond. Because you need to understand those rules. Once you understand those rules, there are about 10 rules that will guide you. Once you can walk through that rules, plus your own investment goal and the knowledge you are getting from different, you know, materials and the lessons and, you know, videos you are watching and trainings you are attending, it will help you. Because if you really want to earn more in equity market, you need to up your knowledge. Like I said, equity market is one of the best way to make what? To make more money, to create wealth. For that, you need to work with really, it's only that this part of the world, people are shy or not visit, you know, to discuss how to create wealth. And Bible said that it gives us wisdom what to create wealth. It's the word that gives us wisdom and knowledge to create. It's not by power. That means you need to go for it. You can't sit down and be making money. If that what you need to know, let God teach you how to work. And knowledge come and by learning. If you are not learning, if you are not training, how will you get the knowledge? How will you get the understanding? You need to up your, you know, your game in terms of in financial education. In any what it costs to let it go, because you know you are learning to send your money and errand in the right place. Like I said, there are different investment window. At this point, where should I be? If you have knowledge, you should know where to edge against inflation and at the same time preserve your capital. These are the things it's good for you to share, to learn, sorry, to learn more about the financial market. Yes, Presco was up for the week, gaining a 9.28. You know that Presco was up because the dividend is around the corner. For you to qualify for the dividend, it's at a Friday. If you are in the stock as at Friday, that means you have qualified for the $2 dividend that will be marked down on Monday. That's for people. For me, if you are in Presco, as I said, it's one of our defensive stock. If you have gotten the first video on strategies on how to invest profitably in a changing market dynamics and recession, this is a part of the stock that you can put in your portfolio for defensive, especially this Presco, knowing that also the government policy on agriculture is also impacting on this sector. We expect the numbers to start looking up and more attractive to support the price. Nimet, fine. This is a sector that also you should consider. Nimet is one of the cheapest company in that sector in terms of activities. You know, after DSK mentioned, you know, me and Baker fixing, I think DSK Nimet should be the next and one of the cheapest one so far now. But also there's something that's happening in that sector. If you look at the way DSK is moving, and DSK is also discussing with the GSK, you know, UK already on the COVID-19 vaccine, and if that is achieved and they get good results, it's going to be one of the, you know, the agent or one of the channel for that. That's going to impact on their what, on their bottom line. Also, don't forget that also one of the major director in Nimet is also discussing with World Health. I learned that he has going to present also the vaccine, you know, they have discovered for COVID-19. If it's came true, it's also, you know, Nimet is one of those companies that will be, you know, and this is a period when you are, you know, you have the concept to sell the vaccine, is a boost for you and you make more money. That means it's not only in Nigeria, it's something that will go general and you're going to make money for it. For me, I think the healthcare sector has come, you know, to with improved activities. Well, like I said, that about the month of May, I'll be early, late April, you know, CBN was injecting funds in this sector and would not expect it to impact on their second quarter. But going forward, I see that, you know, at the end of Q3 that we're already in, I see a better number from this healthcare sector. And knowing that the Nimet, as if you look at Nimet activities, they are very conservative, and if you look at their cost of operation, it's not much, but injection of this fund will boost activities in that company. I see that investor can also look the way of Nimet at this point, especially if you are thinking long. But also, you might not expect, you know, a good dividend that from them, but for capital protection, you can look at it. And also, this company has September as year end. We expect that by this end of June, we're not looking forward to see the third quarter, no earnings of this company. If the fund injected will start impacting for the last quarter of the year, the last quarter of the year for Nimet, because we're already in the month of the last quarter for them. September is the end of their financial year. If you see the third quarter that is coming now and you see improvement in that number, I think for me, we expect that this company should, where investors look at that September is around the corner. You know that there are only two companies that have September, no, as year end in the market, no, Nimet and Vitafoam. You need to look at these two companies now that were close to the end of their year and were already in third quarter. Their third quarter result will give insight what we should expect from them at the end of the year. That is for the top gainers. You know, you can see this Adobe, you know, PLC, this former, you know, Forte Oil. You can see that the company is just gaining just 7.73. For me, Jais Bank is a bank that you actually should also look at. This is a company that, if you look at their first quarter result and full year, tells you that there's something working for them. That means this lockdown might affect more banks because of activities of the economy. But for this company that share profit, they don't give loan, what weigh down their profit is not much. But for other companies, because they are making provision for the expected bad loans and loans that will be delayed according to CBN rules in my way down. But for this Chinese bank, I see that it's what you can look at now. The net position ahead of their second quarter number. Also knowing that the second quarter number will be in the market around the July 24. That means next week you can start looking the way of this company now. And the livestock is another stock you should also look at. Now, these are one of the penny stock in that agro business. And you know, because of the interest of the government, not only that, the poultry business is waxing strong because we want to feed ourselves now. I think with the shareholding structure of this company, I see that there's a goodies coming for investor in this in terms of capital appreciation. What we saw in Nimet might likely repeat itself in livestock. We need to also look at and start looking the way of this company gradually, because once they start posting positive results, we can see that in their first quarter result was not a bad number. You know, there's improvement. If you look at their full year for 2019, there's improvement. And you know, many people that invest with fundamental, this will look at, but we will look at technical and fundamental together before we can advise. But I can see that there's a sign that one can start looking the way of, especially if you're a long-term investor, the welfare. The role of what livestock for Cabri, you know, this consumer sector, it is what investors are, the public are, they have their earning, they can consume. And also knowing that Cabri don't have, you know, a large, you know, product line. Yes, their result for Q1 and full year was not bad. They also to pay 36 kobo dividend, but I'll tell you that, no, the product line of this company is going to also constrain their performance in terms of profitability. But for me, the more the economy improve, all the consumer goods are likely to look up as people consume. Because as we speak now, most of these consumer, consumer goods producers or manufacturers, most of their products are still, you know, on the shelf, because the consumption rate of people has really dropped because of what they are earning less now, and the economy is not smiling. On that, you have to also be careful looking the way of Cabri. But for the losers for the week under review, I will tell you that the Linkage Assurance topped the losers chart. You know, losing negative, losing 14.89%, followed by Nigeria Bureau, WAPIC Insurance. WAPIC is profit taking, and Linkage is also market sentiment. Also for Nigeria Bureau, is profit taking. This is stock that rallied from almost 28 to about 36 naira, and people are selling down now. It's all profit taking. For Cornell was adjusted for full year dividend of 2 naira, why profit taking also has hit 11 PSE with the former Mobi. No, for the week it lost 9.97. Abico, I know, also lost. Julius Vega, no, Julius Vega also lost for the week. This also market forces for me for Julius Vega. This is a price that is attractive now. You can also be looking at what to do with Julius Vega at this point. For internal PSC, this one we have to be very careful, because the numbers for many years now have been down and they are not looking up again for now, and the dividend is not coming. It has to be also, the sector is struggling, the oil and gas sector is struggling in Nigeria, because we don't know what is happening. If you look at all the numbers coming from that sector, they are not too good, except for Seplat that has potential because of what the crude oil thing, but also all the numbers from that sector are looking southward. We have to also be very careful. Therefore, me, ETI at this point look attractive. You know, at the price it is now, investor can be thinking of what to do. But like Unity Bank, like if you are following us even on the platform on our YouTube, I've said it earlier, this is a bank that has about almost 250, negative shareholders fund. For me, investors will also be very careful. Investors be careful, because we don't know what will happen. And when a company is having a negative shareholders fund, you don't think of that is accumulated loss. You don't think of dividend coming from them. And this is a low cap stock that anything can happen. And if their Q2, go this the same way, even when it is positive as Q1, but because of the negative shareholders fund that have been there for like 4 years now, even 5 years, we have to be very careful. Any day, anytime, you can hear story from the company. You can see what happened to Sky Bank. We don't want investors to also lose money in that manner again. You have to be very careful. On that note, we'll draw the curtain here. I say God bless you and enjoy your new trading week. See you and God bless you.